Hi, this is Amy from the Montshire, and it's seed week. This week, we are going to be doing all things seeds. So join me, we'll have experiments, we'll have scavenger hunts, all sorts of different cool things to try. So first off though, we should talk about what a seed is. And most plants have seeds. There's a few weird ones that don't. Those tend to be more the prehistoric plants like ferns and mosses. They have something called spores, but other plants have seeds, and that's how they make new plants. In a lot of cases, the plant makes a flower. Again, here pine trees and conifers are a little different, but that flower gets pollinated and forms a seed, and then it's that seed that develops that can make a new plant. And a seed is pretty basic. So why don't we zoom in here? And I have a chickpea here. And this is one of those seeds that we're gonna do some experiments with if you have one. You may not have chickpeas at home. They look like this when they're dried. And then this one I've been soaking. And the seed itself really only has three parts. And I'm gonna try to break this open so we can see that. Oh, here we go. Okay, so see this little nibbin thing on the end? That's probably really hard to see. But that is where the new plant would develop from. That's called the embryo. And a little bit more of it's inside the seed. And then the seed itself has a coat on it. I can peel that off probably. Yeah, there's a seed coat. And then, oh, and now you can see the embryo a little bit better maybe, sticking up there. And then the rest of the seed is called an endosperm. And that is the food for the baby plant when the plant starts to grow. And that is energy and food. And so when you plant a seed underground, it doesn't initially get sunlight. We think of plants making their own food. But to get started, they have to have some food. So the seed is basically the food for the new growing plant. So check that out later. And then what we're gonna be starting with is an experiment that we're gonna run all week, maybe 2 weeks, depends on how long you wanna let it go. And for this experiment, we're gonna be sprouting different types of seeds. Now, to get your seeds, some of you maybe have seeds that you were gonna plant in the garden. Whatever you have should be great, doesn't matter. I decided to do my experiment instead with things I had in my kitchen, but you can do either, depending on what you have. Hopefully you can find something. And what you're gonna need is some sort of bag. Could be an old bread bag. I'm gonna use a little Ziploc bag. Nothing too fancy. And then some paper towel. And you just wanna get your paper towel a little wet. I have a little bit of water here where I've been soaking some seeds. You're just gonna get that wet. Probably easier to do at the sink, but I'm at my kitchen table. So, don't want it too wet, but a little drip isn't a big deal. You're gonna put that inside your baggie. Spread it out the best you can. Doesn't have to be perfect. That will work. So you've got your wet paper towel in a bag. Again, you could have used whatever bag you had around. And then you're gonna put your seeds in there. And I'm gonna put 4 different seeds in here, a couple of each. So I am going to use some popcorn that I have that's this red color. I'm actually curious when it sprouts, whether it'll be red or not. I'm gonna use my chickpeas. I have this seed in my cabinet. I didn't label it. It's could be wheat, it could be farro, it could be barley. I don't know. It's been in my cabinet for a while because I don't know what it is. So we're gonna use that. And then I actually had some alfalfa seeds that are designed for sprouting to eat. So I'm gonna try those seeds. If you're using bigger seeds, you may, like the garbanzo beans, I actually soaked them first, just for like an hour or so. So if you're doing a big bean or a big garbanzo bean, it just gives them a little bit of a head start. But again, probably doesn't matter in the long run. And then you're just gonna take your seeds, spread them out in on your paper towel. So I'm gonna put my garbanzo beans in. I'm gonna put my popcorn, a few popcorns in. I'm gonna get these little whatever seeds in and I'm kind of trying to spread them around, but some of them are falling, and those alfalfa, I don't think I'm gonna be able to pick up from my plate. Oh yeah, here we go. All right, so there's your experiment. You're going to take your bag and don't seal it up, but just kind of make, do something like that. Or if you're using a bag like this, you could just kind of fold over the edge. And then you're going to find a spot to put it that's not too cold, somewhere that's maybe a little bit warm. You're going to check on it every day. You may need to add water if it's somewhere that's drying out, but you may also be able to go all week without adding water. And then I just want you to check on your seeds. You may want to draw what they look like each day. You might notice changes that you'd want to keep track of. See what happens. Some of the seeds might not sprout. We're not going to know that until we try it, but maybe some will. So what I'm going to be doing is checking in with you all week for different activities and experiments, and then later in the week we'll all check in together on this experiment and see if anything has happened. All right, I'll see you soon. Bye.